Hey, what's up guys? Grant here, popping in with another subscriber giveaway. I went down and picked up a Nintendo Switch with Mario Kart 8. I'd like to give it to one of you. So I got a link down in the description for some subscriber appreciation. We'll see you there. Hey guys, I'm Nate, and today we've got a fun experiment. We're going to try and see if we can make our very own magnetic putty. There's a couple different methods we're gonna try, and both of them involve using this synthetic iron oxide, also called magnetite. This whole 1 pound bag is available on Amazon for less than 10 bucks, and it goes a long way. As a first experiment, I have a little blob of silly putty, and we're just gonna see what happens if we mix some of our magnetite powder into the silly putty. Now this bag is full of magnetic powder, and you can see that a magnet does stick to it quite well. I don't want to get any of the magnetic powder directly on the magnet because it's a very fine grained powder and it would be nearly impossible to get it all off. But I'll try pouring some onto a plate and then playing with the powder a little bit with our magnet under the plate. You can see it's a very fine powder. It does have some clumps, but those break up into just dust, really. You can see how dark this stuff is, and that does transfer onto your skin. If you touch this stuff with your bare skin, like, it's just like charcoal dust. It gets on you, and it just kind of likes to stay on. All right, so there is our black magnetic powder. Let's see what happens if we bring our magnet underneath it on the plate. Cool little shard spike things forming. Pretty similar to what happened when we made our ferrofluid, except in this case, it's not a fluid, it's just a powder. We've got our magnetic powder and we've got a little bit of silly putty. If you're not familiar with silly putty, it's a rubbery, gooey substance that is like an extremely, extremely thick liquid. So this is already a pretty neat putty. I wanna see what happens if we mix a bunch of our magnetite powder into this and see if we can get a magnetic putty that way. Okay, at this point, our putty is completely black. There's no trace of orange coloring left to it, so the magnetite powder has really overpowered all of the orange color that was in it. Let's see how well this is attracted to a magnet. Oh, I would say definitely, definitely more attracted. And now it sort of just jumps up to it. One of the things I've seen done with commercial magnetic putty is you can put some of it near a magnet and it sort of just swallows the magnet whole. This is a pretty powerful magnet, so let's see if we can get that result using this putty. Despite leaving our homemade magnetic putty next to a magnet for a while, it didn't ever really envelop the magnet. It started grabbing onto one end of it and then just kind of stopped. I think the silly putty itself is just a little bit too rigid and durable, and then when you add in the magnetite, it gets even more rigid by just a little bit, and in the end, it's so hard that it doesn't really like to move very much. Another cool little thing you can do with magnetic putty often is pull a little strand away from the main blob using the magnet, and again, it's attracted to it, but it doesn't really pull it hard enough that it can stretch out very well. While having black silly putty that's pretty much normal but it's attracted to a magnet might be cool, it's not really what we're going for. So let's see if we can use a different recipe and make a slightly softer putty. One recipe I've seen says you can use 2 parts multi-purpose white glue and 1 part laundry starch, and we're gonna add 1 part of our magnetite powder to that as well. Let's see what we can get using that. This won't make a very large batch, but it might be about the same as the size of our silly putty glob. So it'll be a good comparison. This is not a very smooth texture at this point, but I'm going to keep working it and see if it gets any better. And it is already getting a little bit stiffer, so I think that's a good sign. Still very sticky though. That might just be because it likes to stick to the rubber on my gloves. So I'm gonna try this without gloves. Sticky on my hands as well, not just the gloves. I'm assuming the sticky is from the glue. So maybe adding a little bit more starch will stop it from being as sticky. Maybe this recipe is just really, really sticky. That seems to be helping. And it's still ooey gooey, but it's not sticking to my hands nearly as much. So I think it's just getting just the right balance of starch and glue, because now this is turning into a putty that I can actually handle a little bit. So now we know if we're mixing our glue and our starch and it's too sticky, we just need to add a tiny bit more starch, not even a lot. I just dipped it down in one spot a little bit, and now I can handle this and it like is really not sticking to my hands anymore. If you want to make homemade silly putty, I'd say this is a pretty good recipe. It is a little bit thinner, but it's pretty similar. I wonder if I can bounce the ball of this stuff. Not on this material, it just stuck right to it. Well, a little. It bounces off the workbench. Not as high of a bounce as silly putty, but a bounce. All right, let's try adding our magnetite powder to this. And I'm going to try and add about one spoonful. I think we have a good putty. The question is whether we have a good magnetic putty. Let's grab our magnet and see how well it's attracted to it. Ooh, I would call that pretty attracted. Let's try the same test we did with the silly putty. Let's just make a ball and see how easily it moves to the magnet. It jumps right out of my hand nicely. Putting the magnet near it, it immediately starts stretching out to grab onto it. The silly putty itself didn't do much to grab around the magnet. Let's see what happens if we just leave this putty near the magnet for a few minutes. That did a much better job than the silly putty. It reached all the way around our magnet. This magnet, compared to the weight of the putty, is probably too big for it to move with its own magnetic draw, but some of the putty reached over the top of the magnet and down in front and grabbed onto that side too. So it really did a pretty good job of enveloping the magnet. This works pretty well. It's a good magnetic putty. I think the natural step at this point is to make a lot more magnetic putty. We now have one big old blob of putty. This is a lot of goo right here. And if you just let it sit for a second, it just starts stretching itself out. Slowly stretches itself out. So now we want to try and turn this into this. And we're just gonna pour our powder on top of it, all around it. My hands are gonna end up so black from this. See? Getting black already. We now have a pretty giant blob of our putty. Let's do a test and see how magnetic it is. I'd say it's definitely sticking. And of course, this blob weighs way more than our magnet, and so it doesn't just get lifted up into the air. It just sort of grabs at a portion of it, whatever's closest to it, and stretches that out. Let's try watching our magnetic putty swallow some of our powerful magnets. I would definitely call this experiment a success. Mixing the magnetite powder with silly putty, not so much. It is magnetic, but it's too stiff to really react to the magnets. But using our homemade putty made from white glue and liquid starch, we were able to make a perfect consistency of putty so that when we mix the magnetite powder into it, it reacts really well with the magnet. I mean, the magnet gets drawn onto it, it sticks to it. It pulls the putty away from the blob, and of course, if we put the blob in the putty, it just gets swallowed. And you can see this is in real time. I'm not speeding up this footage. Like, the magnet just gets drawn down into this stuff really quickly. Of course, this is an extremely powerful magnet, but we have a lot of magnetic putty, so it seemed fitting to me. Guys, there's still more for you to see. That little box up at the top will transport you directly to our last video. Go check it out. That box at the bottom will show you what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. And if you hit this bomb in the center, you'll be subscribed to the channel so you never miss another video again. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.